this. I think it was a really good read.
Oh, God, I'm glad you sound really proud. Do you have any anecdotes you want to share or any
about
words?
Soha?
Yeah, something from that we might not find in the book.
Well, I mean, you know, first of all, I'd like to congratulate her. I think this is a great occasion. I think she's done really well with this thing. Soha Bia, you know, obviously went to a wonderful university. I went to two wonderful universities, actually. She went to Oxford as well as the London School of Economics and was highly qualified and was working in Citibank and, you know, all set to do that. And then she came to stay with me for a summer and quit her job and join movies. And I'm not sure how my parents felt about that, but she's of course has her mother's blood and genes as well, and was drawn to this profession. There was a time, you know, that she's misleading. She seems quiet and very, very sweet and polite, which she is, and she's a source of strength for us, and I'm very happy she lives in the same city as I do. But she had gone out to dinner once. I want to tell the story. It was before she met Kemu here. And I hope he doesn't mind me saying this, but it was kind of a date. He was a really wealthy guy, and he was a big industrialist, and everyone was kind of wondering how this was going to work out. And he was talking to Soha, and Soha was really bored. I don't know if she was already seeing Kunal and...
Oh.
Okay. All right, I don't know. No, in the sense that, you know, just went out to be polite. Anyway, she's out at this dinner and her friend messages her and says, you know, how's it going? And she replies, you know, he's really boring. And she sends the message to the guy she's having dinner with. And now this is Soha. She doesn't skip a beat. She says to the guy, excuse me, can I borrow your phone, please? Takes it, deletes it, gives it back, and carries on.
Well,
my sister. Yeah. So, you know, I've known her for a very long time. I'm very happy she's on my side.
I'm rarely intimidated by anyone, as I'm sure most of the media knows. But if there's one person in the family that I'm completely in awe of, I think it's Soha.
Thank you so much.
I mean, obviously, just a little nervous taking a cue from Kunal. Obviously, being that when I'm at dinner with Saif and Soha, I'm like, oh my God, I'm never going to understand this conversation. If Kunal can't, there's no way that I can. So Soha's always been so polite. She's always been like, yeah, hi, what's up? So yeah, okay, did you buy anything? So what's the gossip? So I'm like, oh God, I feel so small and lame. Is this what it's really going to be? And then I was like, but it's okay. But I think we found our way. And if there's anyone in the family that I think any of us turn to when Amma's all worked up and fired up, then there's just one person that can control the situation, and that's Soha. So, I mean, I truly, truly believe that she is the torchbearer of this family. And this title it doesn't do justice, because famous or not famous, she is the grounding in which all of us stand on. And I've truly seen that the way she has compassionately and with just as a breaking heart when her father was passing away. I've never seen any daughter. I'm a daughter. But I don't know if I could have done the way she looked after him. And that, in my eyes, to me, is a solid woman. So here's to you, Soha. And I'm sure Abba's listening to all of this. Yes, so fantastic. Let's hear it for none other than the brightest in the family, Soha Ali Khan.
Thank you so much. Oh, Kareena, that was really sweet. And it's just so nice. You guys clearly seem really, really proud of Soha. And yeah. And also, just so you guys know, like, the book is an easy read. I know people talk about how she uses big words. I understood everything in the book. So don't be scared. Don't let them scare you off. Oh, that's lovely. I'd like to now call your mom on stage. Would you like a tissue, sir? Are you okay?
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
Thank you.
Really hard wind blowing. Yeah. Could you please have Sharmila ji on stage?
Absolutely. Everybody was so entertaining.
Yeah.
It's been
Wonderful to hear all of them, yes.
Such heartfelt messages for your daughter. And
wow. I know, it's like being at the premiere of Iti Srikanto, right? That was your first film, yes? And today is also a kind of debut.
Well, I think we're laughing more now.
Yes, that's true. That's true, yes.
No, but I mean, I know, like she says, you're one of her biggest critics. But are you proud?
I know, they're making me sound like a bit of an ogre, right?
No. Yeah? No, you just seem like a good mom. Hmm. Yeah, no, that's what I was supposed to say, right? Yeah. No, yeah. But are you proud that she's written this book? Like, yes. Genuinely, are you...
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Because it's really not easy to write a book. Exactly. I mean, you can talk well, you can write paras, you can write columns, but to have the discipline to actually write that many chapters and make it into a book, yeah. I think it's great. And well done, Soha. Really, very, very proud of you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
That's so lovely. You want to read something out of the book? You have an excerpt you'd like to share with us?
Yeah, lovely.
Sorry?
Want me to share something?
Yes, please. If you have an anecdote that you'd love to share about
not
your daughter.
As funny ones as all these guys been telling
no,
you.
No, but...
But I remember certain things which are really... I think I've heard the most sad and poignant sentence from her, which aged, I think, 6, which have stayed with me all these years. I remember when we went to Delhi from Mumbai, we made a shift. All of us left to stay with my mother-in-law, who was not keeping so well. And so that meant change of school, change of everything. And one night I was reading a bedtime story to Soha, and suddenly I found her crying, you know, really sobbing her heart out. So I said, Soha, what's happened? What's happened to you? Why are you crying? And she said, Amma, I cannot remember my friends' faces. And I mean, just imagine, I think that's the terrible thing if you cannot remember. Of course, I could have produced pictures and photographs, but at that moment, I really felt that, I mean, how awful it must be for a little girl. Yeah. And then another occasion, we were walking around Patodi. We have a biggish house and we have a smallish house. Anyway, we were taking a stroll. And suddenly, Sohabia says, Amma, who is Bhai going to marry? And again, she was about 6 years old or something. So I said, I have no idea who Bhai is going to marry. So she says, well, Bhai is a prince. So whoever he marries will be a princess, yeah. Right? So I said, yes, if you say so, true. So then who am I going to marry? Where will I find a prince? And then she adds, she says, well, after much thinking, princes are very difficult to find, like domestic staff. So to distract her, so I looked at this, like I said, we had a biggish house and a smallish house and a kind of a khandar, like a ruin. So we were passing that. So I said, Soha, so that's going to be your house. You know, when you get married, we'll give it to you. We'll do it up, of course. So she was kind of alarmed. She said, but Amma, that's terribly dangerous for children. And she was 6. And then she said, but who's going to look after my children? Can I take Suraya B from Bhopal? So this was really forward planning. But Soha, it's happened to you now, and you still don't have a maid. But Suraya B is a couple of older, you know, couple of years older. So I don't think you can have Suraya B. So she was kind of always into forward planning, even then.
Wow, that was a really smart question, and it was really sad. I can't remember my friends' faces.
I know. I mean, just think
that's
about
really,
it.
This book is a beautiful tribute to all the people in your life, like everyone on stage here, and your father who's not here. And I think, I don't know if you guys noticed just now, it's just this beautiful moment, Sharmilaji, when you were reading, and she held your sari pallu, and your son came and held your page for you, and it's just
Perils of wearing a sari.
I wanted to, if you guys don't mind, I want to play a quiz with you guys, a quick quiz on who knows Soha best. It's the who knows Soha best test. Are you guys ready for this? It's a quick, just 5 questions. There will be points given out. There will be a winner and a loser.
What's the hamper?
You will be named in the next title of her next book. That is a prize. All right, so are you guys ready? It's a quick quiz, yeah? All right, the first question is, Who is Soha's favorite author?
Oh, God. Nobody.
Really? Nobody? No? Okay. Who is
Michael Connelly? Joe Nesbo. Joe Nesbo.
Is that the correct answer? It's actually
Margaret Atwood.
It's Julian Barnes.
Oh, well.
They don't actually know me at all, these people.
But you're such an eclectic reader, you know, Joe Nesbo to Julian Barnes to Margaret Atwood.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Well, then your
mom... next to each other on the bookshelf.
There we go. So your mom and Saif get 10 points each in this first question. All right, the next question is, what makes Soha lose her temper?
Me.
Yeah, one thing that makes Soha lose her temper. Really, that's the answer?
Not getting her food on time?
Ooh.
Yeah, but Kunal first.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well done, Kunal. You get the points for that question. That's any consolation.
What's the real answer?
Yeah, hunger, like anyone else.
Okay.
Blood sugar falls and you lose
perspective. But genuinely, it's Kunal first.
Yes, always.
Okay.
Kunal is equal to hunger.
Kunal equal to?
Hunger.
Fair. Okay. All right, question number three, guys. This is a tough one. And
I know the answer to this?
I mean, I think I know the answer. What is the name of the Tagore ancestral home? No?
Presumably, Amma knows the answer to this.
Jora Shako.
Yes, that is the correct answer.
This is rigged.
No, I've got questions for you guys as well.
This is supposed to test whether you've read the book or not.
Exactly. I got all these questions from the book, by the way, guys. So, all right. Who is Soha's closest? Who is Soha closest to in the family?
That's a very dangerous question right
that's
now.
That's easy.
Okay.
I'm currently sitting next to Kunal and my mother.
Who's going
to...
Inaya.
Well
played. That's the most diplomatic answer.
Even though I'm furthest
most
from her right now.
Answer.
Well played.
You can't have fights after that. No, but yeah.
Well,
mother or Inaya.
Wow. Yes. Please, Sava. Who is it?
Soha is extremely fair with everyone. You'll find that she... has time for all of us. She loves us equally, and she actually, I have noticed that when you're with her, she gives you a one-on-one and she's with you when she's with you.
So I'm actually everyone's favorite. It's true. I mean, she's
very fond of Amma.
Who are you? Okay, who are you closest to?
What do you mean?
Oh, everyone. Everyone's close to you and you're close to
everyone. Everyone loves me the most.
That's your answer. Everyone loves you the most. Yeah. All right, great, guys. This is going not so badly. Just your mother who knows all the answers to everything. Okay, the last question. What social media platform does Soha use the most?
Anyone know?
Your friends are shouting the answer out. Instagram? Is that the right? Instagram.
But I'm quite lazy. I just sort of post on all three. Kind of... Instagram, Twitter.
Yeah. But Instagram, everyone's saying...
Sure, let's go with Instagram.
All right.
So that's the only one I see her posting on.
So you've been...
I think she thinks I'm stalking on Instagram.
All right, well, great. You all got that answer right. So you all get 10 points. I have no idea who has what points.
Where can we redeem these points?
Fair. Come chat to me after the conference. And the last question, guys, because there's one last question, and this is a tough one. How many chapters are there in her book, The Perils of Being Moderately Famous?
20?
What? No.
Do you know?
10?
It is 20.
No,
it's
18.
11.
19.
19. 10.
You said you're writing the 17th chapter when you write your pregnancy chapter.
9.
Then 9 chapters.
What? nine chapters?
Kareena said 9.
Yeah. Kareena, congratulations, you get 10 points. Well, thank you, guys. Well done. You played fabulously. You don't win anything, but now we know a little bit more about Soha. Any last words, Soha, that you'd like to say to everyone out there?
I just want to say thank you again for everyone for being here. And it's really special for me to have really thought about all the memories that I have and putting this together in a book. It's available to buy. Thank you to my family for being here, and Kaniz for hosting, and Penguin for publishing, and everyone for looking after me, the media for being here, my friends and family. It really means a lot, and this evening wouldn't have been this evening without all of you, so thank you.
Thank you so much. So a big round of applause for Soha Ali Khan, ladies and gentlemen. Very special day. Congratulations
Thank
again.
You.
Like
Thank
your
you
mom
so
said,
much.
It's a huge feat writing a book, and you did it. You wrote a book. All of us just have it on our to-do lists and our bucket lists, and you did it. You've done it. It's amazing. I think now we're going to have... Oh, yes. We're going to open the... No, not yet. But we are going to open the floor for the media out there. A quick Q&A for you, Soha. Sorry? Sorry? So we're going to, it's not the photo op just yet. We're just going to do the Q&A first. Okay, so could you, sorry ma'am, someone will come bring you the mic just now.
Hello. Soha, congratulations to you. I'm standing here in front of you.
Ji.
Pehle to ye bataiye ki aap how you are going to handle acting and writing together. And what is your next project?
Well, I've already finished writing the book, and actually the timing was very good because I started writing the book and I discovered that I was pregnant, and then I became larger and larger, and I was not in film, so I could use those 8 months to really focus on writing. So it was very fortuitous, and in fact, there's a chapter on becoming pregnant and the pregnancy because that was all I was thinking about, so I said I might as well write about it. And now, going forward very briefly, you know, I'll be going back to work. At the moment, Project Inaya is taking up all of my time. And after that, I'll be doing Sai Bibi Gangster Returns next.
Thank you.
Soha, congratulations. It's me.
Yeah. Bhavna ji.
Yes. So congratulations. It's been a wonderful evening. And I love the way the family spoke. I love the way you read it. I feel so proud of you. And
Thank
I'm so happy to see Sabha here because one doesn't get to see Sabha so often. My question is that there is a family joke, your family joke, that Soha speaks impeccable English and writes impeccable English. And if anybody speaks wrong English, she immediately corrects it. So I think you must be the editor's delight. And I would love to know from the editor because your copy must have had no correction at all.
Ask Gurveen is over there. You can't miss her in her silver spangly dress.
She has to answer this because as an author, I want to know. Wow. Oh, she needs an applause for this. Wow.
She actually sent it to me to look at it and I misunderstood. So I was actually checking all the commas and the punctuation. And she said, no. We have someone who'll do that. You just check the facts. But I'd already done all of that myself.
Typical Soha. Classic Soha.
Yeah, hi Soha. Oh yeah.
Are there any more questions?
Yeah, yeah.
Someone back there.
Hello, Sharmila ma'am.
Oh yeah.
Hello. Sharmila ma'am, aapka career 50 saal se zyada raha hai film industry mein. Aapne itna kuch dekha hai. आजकल बहुत लोग अपनी ऑटोबायोग्राफी लिख रहे हैं कभी आपके मन में ऐसा आया कि आप भी कुछ लिखें अपने एक्सपीरियंसेस शेयर करें इतना कुछ हो रहा है इंडस्ट्री में भी और देश में भी
नो आई थिंक दैट्स अ वंडरफुल आइडिया और मैंने सोचा है जरूर मगर एग्जैक्टली यू नो आई बीन थिंकिंग बट आई हैवंट रियली पुट पेन टू पेपर एंड सोहा हैज बीटन मी टू इट मे बी सोहा कैन राइट माई बुक हाउ इज दैट या
सैफ एक सवाल आपसे भी है कि आप बहुत बड़े बुक लवर माने जाते हैं बहुत किताबें पढ़ते सब जानते हैं आपका नॉलेज भी काफ़ी है अगर आपको एक किताब लिखनी पड़ी तो वो किस मसले पर आप लिखना चाहेंगे और क्या लिखना चाहेंगे
Yes, ghost stories.
Why so?
Just chilling tales of life in the movie industry. Yes, something like that. Or political satire.
Or a comedy.
Or a comedy. Yes. It's a comedy, horror, or political satire. Not sure. My mother did want to write a book once on me. And the title was going to be, Oh, Saif. No? bestseller.
Yeah, hello.
Can't be. Hi, can't be written. No?
One more question over there.
Hi, Soha. Yeah. Congratulations for the book launch. I wanted to know whether in future you will be writing some fiction books too? Or are you planning to? Some stories?
After that, if Kunal hasn't completely crushed her confidence totally.
Thank you.
I really feel if I was going to write a book now, it would be on the first 6 weeks of parenting, because that's all I can think about.
Sounds like a real bestseller.
It would be funny. It would be funny. It would have you in tears and like I am at the end of every day. But maybe, yes, I think I would like to explore the limits of my imagination and try and push them. Right, Kunal?
Yeah.
Do you have plans of writing more books?
Yeah, I think so, maybe. Cool. Let's see how this one does.
Hi, Soha. Yeah. Soha, bahut bahut mubarakbad aapko. Pehle to book bahut achhi thi. In future, agar aapko koi script likhne jaye to kya casting kisko kya jayega?
Casting? Main to script likhi hai. Casting director depends on the script. Abhi to kahani bhi nahi malum, ka socha hi nahi humne. But there's quite a star cast on the stage at the moment.
Okay, but you know.
I'm only talking about myself.
Yeah, we're going to take the last question. We have one more question. Oh.
Soha. Hi, Soha.
Well, sorry, sir, you've asked the question. We're just going to ask one of the audience members. Thank you, though. But you have.
So, what was the toughest chapter to write?
Hi, Ninna.
Good evening.
The toughest chapter to write was probably the one called A Working Actor. The others sort of fell together. But really, my struggle has been with my profession as an actor, which is such an important part of my life, but also the insecurities that come with, the comparisons that are made, which are very difficult to live up to. And as I said, you know, they're very big shoes to fill, and I have very small feet. So that, I think, and striking the right tone with the readers, you know, such that I'm talking about my insecurities and my failures and my, you know, all the learning steps that I've come across, but not being too hard on myself, I think, was the most difficult thing for me. So I would write at 2 a.m, and then I would reread it at 4 p.m. and take away some of it and say, no, you know, it's all right. And then, so I think that for me was the biggest struggle.